marching on with our friends by our sides, we join together in slowly capturing our dreams, day by day, and face each day with its demands, ups and downs, growing and sharing, and as always, marching. There's always a strong shoulder to lean on that brings a light to lead and ease the way. A friend we trust and confide in who makes it all worthwhile. Marching through these days, we must hold tightly to our beliefs, feelings, and hopes. As we march on through the days to come, remember to share a smile now and spread laughter in times of darker skies. Our steps may be small today, but just think of the great steps we may take in the future. Where will we be 10 years from now? Marching, always marching, to new adventures, both rewarding and exciting. Our tradition at Hargrave Military Academy marches on. The men and women who built Hargrave were dedicated to education. They had to be. At the turn of the century in rural Virginia, good secondary schools were few and far between. Fearing that the lack of educational opportunity would stunt the intellectual and moral growth of their children, the citizens of Chatham, in concert with Mr. John Hunt Hargrave and Dr. T. Ryland Sanford, united to establish a Christian school affiliated with the Virginia Baptist, where ambitious youths could prepare themselves for college and business. From its beginning in 1909, the campus has changed, but the caring, earnest desire to see young people better themselves remains the same. We do not promise miracles. Rather, we pride ourselves on the small, often hard-won achievements that make Hargrave graduates feel that their time here has been well spent. Decades of expansion and relative prosperity have not diminished our fervor. Whatever it takes, study skills programs, computer labs, new course offerings, Hargrave has consistently kept pace with the academic needs of our students. Not only is the honor roll student appreciated, but also the awkward scholar who makes the basketball team, the timid young woman who becomes a first sergeant, the track star who sweats for a C+ in trigonometry. These are the students that we admire. Standing side by side in full dress uniform, each has a reason to hold his head high. The purpose of Hargrave is to assist young men and women of secondary school age to become knowledgeable, thinking, and responsible citizens of their community, nation, and world. Our educational program is based on rigorous instruction in basic skills and in preparation for further study in the arts and sciences. We believe that to be effective, the educational process must be reinforced by order, structure, and discipline. We feel that the worth, potential, and integrity of the individual must be promoted in every area of school life. For our students to mature spiritually, socially, emotionally, and physically, as well as intellectually, we must seek to achieve our goals within a healthy, wholesome environment in which the Christian faith and principles pervade all aspects of the school program. Parents' Weekend was October 12th, 13th, and 14th. Parents stood in halls outside teachers' doors waiting for personal conferences with faculty about their son's or daughter's progress. Parents usually wish to learn about the areas the student needs improvement, whether that includes studying for tests, keeping notebooks, doing homework, or just improving behavior. Major Sands, Virginia government special class, discuss car purchasing, the U.S. economy, and the Iraq crisis and its effect on us. October 13th, the Assumption of Command ceremony was held. Trustee and alumnus of HMA, Mr. Ben Davenport, yielded command of the institution over to Colonel Thomas N. Cunningham, United States Army, retired.
The undersigned assumes the presidency of Hargrave Military Academy. Signed, Thomas N. Cunningham, Colonel, U.S. Army, retired.
I want to see that in the quadrangle, too.
HMA cadets came to talk with representatives from major Virginia colleges and universities about admissions requirements, scholarships, financial aid, and course offerings. Acceptance to college is not enough. Hargrave teachers and administrators aspire to see cadets succeed in college. Seamstress Mrs. Billy Marilla, who constantly sewed holes, buttons, altered and repaired 350 cadets' uniforms, is one of the most dedicated of personnel.
It's the fact that it takes so long to get together when the kids don't even know their names when they first get here. They finally learn each other's names. Probably the highlight of the year, the game against Fishburne. Fishburne eventually went on and beat North Cross for the championship. And we beat Fishburne and they beat him pretty well. We were confident in the game. We played like we were confident. We played tough. We scored a lot of points. I thought we had some extremely good skill players. We had impact players on defense. Brandon Williams and Hawes and Ricky Bonds and Hagwood. They made things happen.
Chaplain Jack Waddell continued a long tradition at Hargrave on November 5th, 1990, with Religious Emphasis Week. The Reverend Mark Stone of Virginia Beach, a nationally known youth events and retreat leader, was the featured speaker. During the week of events focused on young people's spiritual well-being, cadets were featured in roles as lay readers and prayer leaders. Faculty and staff at the academy provided Christian leadership while highlighting their special musical gifts. Greg J. Battles received the General Douglas MacArthur Cadet Award at a ceremony held in the Walter Davis Memorial Alumni Gymnasium on January 25th. The criteria for the award is the most soldierly performance by a senior class cadet considering academics, athletics, and leadership. Colonel Wayman R. Bishop III, USMC, Deputy Director of the Secretary of the Navy's Military Staff, was the guest speaker and presented the award to Cadet Battles. Fall 1990 cross-country season proved to be a real roller coaster ride. Our team, led by Coach Walker, entered its Virginia Independent Conference schedule and pulled off a strong victory against Miller School. However, the road to a truly outstanding season became quite bumpy with the change of most of the team's members at mid-season. The team's season closed out by participating in the state championship. In true form, Walker finished 20th in a field of 120 for his age division. We really enjoyed the season, though it was a bit hectic. The final record was 1-6 in dual meets.
I'm blazing a trail that leads to vice, so easily enticed by darker means. When out of the wilderness of choice, I hear that one still voice.
3-1 overall for the season. We lost in semifinals to Virginia Independent Conference to the Spencer Conference Championship after playing double overtime and lost 1-0. Overall, I thought we met all our goals except winning the conference, which was one of our goals this season we hope to accomplish. But yeah, I think all our ball players were winners, the way they played as a team, and the way they played with enthusiasm and spirit and tried to do what we hope to accomplish all year and worked on in practice. We had some outstanding ball players. Steve Cook, who was our goalkeeper, was an outstanding ball player for us and great help on defense along with Mark Womack. On offense, we had some outstanding scorers. I think there were 9 different guys on our team who scored goals during the season. We were led in the season in scoring by Jason Perry and John Rampula, who made the all-conference team. John Rampula, for the second year in a row, was all-conference for us. We're looking forward to having a good season next year. We have a lot of returning ball players that should be helpful to us. We should be able to succeed very well in that case.
The purpose of the postgraduate basketball program, besides assisting the late developer and affording the opportunity to improve college board scores, is to allow seniors who've used up their high school eligibility to play and to compete without the loss of a year's college eligibility. It also provides an additional year for growth and maturity, self-confidence, and self-discipline. Best, perhaps, of all, the program allows for exposure and competition against top college and university teams. There were 30 games this year against NCAA Division I, II, III, and NAIA Junior Varsity and Freshman Team. Coach Larry Matthews works with cadets on the development of the fundamentals, refinement of skills, and improvement of certain weaknesses.
Slade Wilkerson's still undefeated. He's 13-0. Mike Cunningham and Greg Anderson, I believe both of them only have one loss on the record. So I've had a lot of pleasant surprises.
How do you like coaching your first year of varsity basketball?
Oh, I love it. Coaching is something that I've always enjoyed doing.
There hasn't been one disappointment. Everybody's done a super job. But we don't have a best player. They all have roles to do. And some of the roles aren't the most glamorous, but they're all doing an excellent job.
Cadence is HMA's yearbook. These 22 students produce both the hardcover yearbook and the new video production. Mr. John Thornton kept all HMA students in a constant supply of military and sports paraphernalia. This year, Christmas at Hargrave began promptly at 4 p.m. Sunday afternoon, December 9th, 1990, with the traditional Hanging of the Green ceremony. An outstanding musical program took place featuring the Handbell Choir of the First Baptist Church of Martinsville and the performing of the Gloria by the Watson Memorial Methodist and United Methodist Church Choirs. Softball team was the only undefeated team with a perfect record in the whole school all year.
Go, go, go!
Go, let's go!
Thank you.
We give this Grammy back now to the Record Academy.
I've fallen and I can't get up.
I have a statement by the President of the United States. The liberation of Kuwait has begun.
Howard Adele. to the salute historian for the class of 91, is Brian Luce. That historian came to us all the way from Massachusetts. That's Brian Talbot.
North Carolina. Virginia. Justin Renier Morris, Severna Park, Maryland. Eric Murray, New York, New York. Reverend Joseph Newell III, Norcross, Georgia. Patrick Allen Newton, South Austin, Virginia. Jay Carmen O'Neill, Floyd, Virginia. James Russell Paisel, John Baptist Rambula, Plainfield, North Carolina. Eduardo Javier Roche Rivero, Merida, Yucatan, Mexico. Ryan Christian Sykes, Chatham, Virginia. Michael Joseph Urban, Greensboro, North Carolina. Landon Dave Lee, Danville, Virginia. Mark Gregory Wongle, South Boston, Virginia. Charles Arthur Wu, Suffolk, Virginia. Stephen Wayne Young, Roanoke, Virginia. Matthew Kenworthy Ahern, Providence, Rhode Island. Sean E. Conyers, Baltimore, Maryland. Christopher Lee Cliff, Manassas, Virginia. Jason Frederick Miller, St. Peter, Minnesota. Sidney Randall Carr, Edmond, Oklahoma. Terry Clark Williams, Spartanburg, South Carolina.
Got you down, yeah. I gotta win it myself, rubber boots and a pill. I'll throw you in.